So today, let's try the last question from the 2023 A-level math exam. This is about a number theory question. It's more like a proof type of question, which is pretty interesting. So let's have a look. First, we have p, q being positive integers with q greater than p. Now, part A, we are going to show that q to the third power minus p to the third power is never a multiple of 5. Well, this statement is false. And to show a statement is false, we can just provide a counter example. So first, let's make it clear. This is false. And then here are my counter example. I'll give you guys two of them. The first one that comes to my mind right away is, firstly though, you cannot use zero because p and q have to be positive integers. So I can do this. Just make sure both of them are multiple of 5. Have a look. I'm going to say q is equal to 10 because q has to be bigger than p, and I will just put p to be 5. And then when you provide a counter example, you should just show it to make it, hey, it does make it false, right? So I am going to put this right here. So we get 10 to the third power minus 5 to the third power. You can work that out. This is 1000 minus 125, which is 875. And if you want to make it like super clear, you should write it as 5 times the whole number. So the result is a multiple of 5. So that would be 175, which is a multiple of 5. A multiple of 5. Right? So it's not never, sometimes it's possible. And now, if you want to be slightly more sophisticated, I would say, this is what you can do as well, especially if the number sometimes is a little bit trickier. So we have q to the third power minus p to the third power. We can factor it. Pay attention to the q and p. This right here, factor the difference of two cubes. It's q minus p times q squared plus qp, okay, I'll write it as p, qp, and then lastly plus p squared. Now, this can always be factored as a product of two things. They are integers. If this is a multiple of 5, then the whole thing will be multiple of 5. So all we need is to make sure q minus p is a multiple of 5. And you can just pick your numbers. So you can say q is equal to 6, p is equal to 1. It will work. You get 216 minus 1, 215. It ends at 5, so it's a multiple of 5. And if you pick 7, then just pick p is equal to 2. So you have infinitely many choices. So that would be perhaps a slightly more mathematical way to do it. But of course, if you just provide a counter example, that should work too. By the way though, just some notations. When you want to mention p minus q is a multiple of 5, you can write this down. 5 divides q minus p. Same thing, right? This and that are equivalent. 5 divides this, that means this is a multiple of 5. Okay, part B, which is the last part, which is quite... All right, next part. Okay, part B, which is the last part. Okay, part B, which is the last part. We have P and Q are consecutive even integers now. Then, if that's the case, we would like to show that Q to the third power minus P to the third power is a multiple of 8. And we'll do this by using algebra. So this is how we can do it. Here is a proof, so I'll write down PEF. So consecutive even integers means the following. If you have, well, you have to have an integer, an even integer first. So let's say if you have 6, then the next one will be 8. If you have 17, no, that's not an even number. If you have 20, the next one will be 22. So if you have something, then the next one will be something plus 2. But you have to make sure the first thing is an even integer first. Because p is smaller, so I'm going to say let p is equal to an even number. And to write an even number, you write it like this. 2 times something, so I'll just say 2k for some k being the integer world. Because it's positive, so that indicates that it's also positive. So p is 2k, so q would be 2k, and then just add 2 to it, right? The next even integer. Now throw them into here, and we'll just work it out. So then we'll say q to the third power minus p to the third power becomes, here we have 2k plus 2. This right here is for the q. Third power that minus p, which is 2k. And then do the third power for that. And then we will see. Expand this. Oh, okay. You can use the binomial coefficient, which is 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1 from the Pascal's triangle. So you can do this, right? It's 1 times 2k to the third power, no 2. And then you add 3 times 2k to the second power, but 2 to the first power. And then continue plus 3, and then 2k to the first power. Notice the power of 2k goes down, right? But the power of 2 goes up. And then finally, plus 1 times 2 to the third power. So that's the expansion, and we just have to work that out. So this right here will be 8k to the third power. And then plus, now this is 4 times 2 is 8, times 3 is 24. And then k to the second power. And then continue, this is 4 times 2 is 8 times 3 is 24, k to the first power, and then lastly, this is 8. Okay, and then minus, right, minus this part here is 8, k to the third power. So that's what we have, and then let's see, this and that can solve pretty nicely. So we have this, and guess what? 24, 24, and 8, they all have a factor of 8. So to show that the final result is a multiple of 8, you should factor out the 8. And then you will get 3k squared plus 3k plus 1. This right here, because k is an integer, so it will be an integer. So we have shown that this is equal to 8 times the integer. So this right here is a multiple of 8. A multiple of 8. And then that's it, we are done. So put box, shading, and that's it.